Jawbreaker truly get his revenge the second time around? We're about to find out.
Keep in mind that a design that worked in the gauntlet won't necessarily work in the labyrinth.
What's that?
You don't know what the labyrinth is? Well, allow me to show you. Six challenges plus six glass panes. The tougher the challenge, the more points the pane of glass is worth. Smash through them all and get past the gates, the final pane, and the bonus points are yours. Now watch out for the robotic rats, because they're coming for you, baby.
Let's check in with Dan Dagny, who is standing by.
Thanks, Tanya. At first glance, it might look like Jawbreaker's Revenge has the edge here, but look a little closer. Jawbreaker's Revenge has two wheels, and BuzzBomb has four. That makes the bomb more controllable, and perhaps even more agile in the tight corners of the labyrinth. The only trouble he'll get into is if he gets anywhere near those powerful jaws. One quick bite, and there will be two Buzz Bombs on this course. Back to you.
Thanks, Dan. There's John Hoffman's Buzz Bomb rolling in on the left, and Tim Berghoffer's Jawbreaker's Revenge on the right. Both have added those vertical glass breakers special for this event.
The labyrinth is hungry. Robots ready? They've been it.
Robots ready.
Straighten his robot out. I'll do the looper points, but we got ourselves an interesting dilemma here, Dan. If he uses Buzz Bomb to break the glass, who gets points?
Well, the judges are saying it'd be Jawbreaker's points, but poor Buzz Bomb probably feels he's got a case.
Jawbreaker's Revenge is handy for the rollers, one of the big point obstacles here in the lab. Looks like he's having some trouble underneath the wrecking balls.
Those two wheels are just spinning on the rollers. Buzz Bomb hits the wrecking balls and slows Jawbreaker down just enough to get in trouble.
Jawbreaker fights through and 25 points. What a cruel hit again.
Jawbreaker's Revenge is having trouble turning in this tight alley of the labyrinth. John Billy watch here, but right now I think the only way he'll get free is if Jawbreaker just decides Buzz Bomb is too unwieldy to keep parrying.
Dan, it just hurts to see all those points go to Jawbreaker's Revenge. Buzz Bomb should get any sense or something. Bottom five.
Ahmet, not that he's trying to, but Buzz Bomb is also helping Jawbreaker's Revenge avoid flipping over in this competition. An extra weight up front counteracts the inertial effect of the jaw rising up when Jawbreaker accelerates. Without Buzz Bomb there, Jawbreaker could flip himself, maybe snap off that glass breaker, and then he'd be in trouble.
Jawbreaker's Revenge fights his way over that jump, still holding tight to Buzz Bomb, and he rams him into that box! That's cruel! He's through, and there's 50 more points for Jawbreaker! Come on! 5 more points for Buzz Bomb! Somebody work me here! Come on, judges! Jawbreaker's Revenge is back out from the box, heading through the slew of yours, and here come the rats! Maybe they'll prompt Jawbreaker to let go of his opponent.
Actually, Ahmet, Jawbreaker will probably use Buzz Bomb to fend off the rats. Let Buzz take the damage and save himself for the next round.
He is smashing that rat against the saloon doors with the little guy. Great rat biding his time. And now he puts this red rat right through the doors, almost flips him. Red rat takes a couple pokes at Jawbreaker's tires, but nothing doing, baby. Jawbreaker's heading over the ramp.
Oh, good timing, Ahmet. Jawbreaker started over the ramp before it was all the way down. Too many contestants wait until it's flat before going, and it springs up before they can split.
Here's Jawbreaker Cam as they prepare to come back out.
Let him go, damn it.
20 points. He goes for it and makes it, and now Gray Rat gets in the action. Oh, don't back the little man. There you go. Hey, Jawbreaker, where it counts. Jawbreaker's Revenge hands into the sand. Sand goes flying. But what little Buzz Bomb is truly the 98-pound weakling, getting sand kicked into space. Jawbreaker spinning those tires quite a bit. Now he's through! 25 more points for Jawbreaker's Revenge! Tim Berghoffer is running an evil but very effective lap.
He's got his first real challenge here, though, Ahmet. Those tire treads are painted sand. It's just wet enough to fill those cracks, and he's lost all traction here. He may be stuck.
So let the little guy go so he can get some points. That's what I do. There's not a lot of time left. Jawbreaker may be content to hold onto his foe, let the clock run out, and walk away with a solid win here. The rats have backed away. You can see those tires spinning, just digging deeper into the pit. There are the contestants. You can see John Hoffman talking to the Jawbreaker guys there, saying, hey, if you let me go, I'll help you get out. I don't see what he's going for, though. The clock is winding down now. And there's the siren. Can Jawbreaker get out of sand? Needs a bonus pain, Dan.
If he can, Buzz Bomb will do what gets the gate down for. Without him, Jawbreaker would probably just flip over every time he tried to accelerate into the gate.
Revenge is moving. He's free from the sand, but he has to hurry. He's still spinning those tires.
He's ruined them for this event, Ahmed. He may be out of the pit, but that sand in his treads is keeping him from getting traction even on the hard labyrinth floor.
He's banking back and forth off the rail, still refusing to let Buzz Bomb go. Poor guy's been beaten up enough this round. There's the buzzer. The boat's pain will go untouched. But there's no doubt who ran away with this event. An impressive display by Tim Berghoffer. John Hoffman just has to laugh. Good sport.
On it, this match was decided in 3 seconds with Jawbreaker's crushing grip. Buzz Bomb may have broken the glass, but Jawbreaker's the one who got the points. Despite his hang up in the sand, Jawbreaker still pitched the shutout.
And Jawbreaker's revenge will be moving on to the fight to the finish. He picked up 85 points and did an excellent job of keeping Buzz Bomb from scoring any.